What's up, everyone? Sage here, back with another Bleeding Edge how-to guide. On this one, we're going to be going over Buttercup, so let's go into those abilities. So first, she's a melee character. I'm going to skip over that. I'm going to go to one of her secret attacks, which is the launch, press X and hold, then release, spin up the back wheel, then launch forward, collecting enemies with a shoulder barge. Longer charge gives more distance. And then going over to her barrel, RT, press RT and hold while moving. Move faster and regenerate health, cost stamina. So instead of her evade, she has this. This is basically her way of getting around and getting out of trouble. And then her specials are yank, chain an enemy and yank them back to you. And then the bottom one, oil slick, drop a puddle of oil that slows enemies. Whiplash, unleash a flurry of whipping blades that damages all nearby enemies. And then her supers, turbocharge, temporarily gain 25% damage, 50% lifesteal, and increases max life by 33%. And then burnout, an epic burnout that damages enemies and knocks them away. So Buttercup, the way you want to use Buttercup, you want to stay around your team to protect them majority of the time. Due to the way how Buttercup is, she cannot be knocked or pushed or anything like that. She's one of those heavy tanks similar to Mecco and Makoto. So basically you want to just stay with your team, try to protect them. But the difference between Buttercup is Buttercup, she's so balanced that you can literally go and use her two different ways. You could either go the damage route easily with the base Buttercup, or you can just stay around your team to defend. And due to the way how she is, she's so balanced around that you could literally play her in these two different ways so easily. So yeah, you could go about doing it that way. But let's get into her first ability. Her first ability, Yank. Yank, basically all it really does is it just grabs an enemy and pulls them towards you. And then I want to go over her oil slick. Her oil slick is one of her best abilities due to the fact that she can literally slow enemies within it. And it's a massive slow. So the way you want to use the oil slick is you want to yank someone to the oil slick. So basically you want to do it that way. Or you can also do a combo to a knockup to a yank to an oil slick. And you get more damage that way. Then you can follow it up with another combo. And these are just ways you can use her yank to oil slick combo in different ways. That way you can maximize your DPS, and or you can try to help slow your teammates with the oil slick, as in, like, say if your teammate's being pushed, you oil slick the enemy, then you back out. Or you can yank the enemy that's attacking your healer or something and pull them off of your healer. That way you could save them that way. Now the whiplash ability is just one of those abilities that you want to just use to clear like turrets or like a healing drop, anything like that, any other item that enemy places on the map. You could just use this to take it off, or you could just use it for a little extra damage, because it doesn't do too much damage, but it does have a short cooldown time, which is 6 seconds, so you can use it more than once within a fight. But the best way you want to use it is to either finish up on a kill, or you want to use it to just clear up on the turrets and stuff, all those other sit down or throw down items that people use during the match, like something like Kalev's healing or Gizmo's turrets. Now going over to her ultimates, I really want to get into these ultimates because Turbocharge is a very good ultimate. It actually gives her a couple effects, as in the damage boost, the lifesteal, and the maximum health. So this is a very good ultimate. I do believe that both of her ultimates are very powerful. Like, both of her ultimates can easily be used to be great and effective towards your team. That way you could actually help and do a lot more, due to the fact that the way how they are, it can actually help to boost her so she could tank more and help to defend your team more. Now her burnout, this is the ultimate that I run majority of the time, due to the fact that it just does a lot of damage and it knocks everyone within her area of activation. So it literally just makes her spin in a giant circle and she just knocks everyone away. You could use this to save people. You could use this to do good damage. There's many ways you could use her burnout. And her burnout does allow her to go through like objects like walls and things. So it will not stop you from doing it. But that's the way you would want to use her burnout. Her burnout does do some pretty good damage. It's not bad of an ultimate. Like I said, both of her ultimates are actually pretty good. So you can use either one. But I would recommend the burnout, because the burnout, that's just what I use. But Buttercup, she's a very simple tank. She's not really difficult to use at all. Her moves are actually pretty easy, and she's actually easy to get the hang of. Her launch is actually also a good ability due to the fact that you could just use it in a charge and then get people off of your team or push somebody to get, say, like more damage. But she's a very easy tank. But that's really it for Buttercup. Buttercup, like I said again, is a very easy tank. She's not hard to master at all. She's very simple and straightforward. So yeah, but that's it for this one. If you want to catch more videos like this and more, please hit that subscribe button. And don't forget to turn on the notifications so you won't miss a video. And we are almost at our sub goal. And we would appreciate if you would spread our channel to your friends and family. That we could help us out a lot more. It's been Sage. And with all that, I'm out.